the Dome finally opened on April 9th, 1965, when close to 48,000 fans came to see the first indoor baseball game ever played. It was an awe-inspiring sight, which excited even those involved from the very beginning.
Before then, we'd only seen it with 100 people maybe in it, and the workmen and everything. But the first day when they opened the thing up and it was full, it really did something to you.
The first game was an exhibition between the New York Yankees and the newly named Astros. And the first homer in the Dome came from the incomparable Mickey Mantle.
All right, here's the leadoff batter now. Mickey Mantle, and he drives one into deep center field. Wynn backs up. He's on the warning track. Here's the wall jump. He can't get it. It's a home run. Mantle hit it 406 feet from home plate. And the roar of the crowd, here it is.
After Mantle's homer, the Astros settled down and wound up winning the game 2-1 on Nellie Fox's single in the 12th inning. A few days later, on April 12th, at the first official National League game played in the Dome, 21 NASA astronauts were on hand to greet their baseball counterparts by throwing out 21 first balls. The game itself was a rather dull affair, with the Phillies shutting out the Astros 2-0. The Dome finally opened on April 9th, 1965, when close to 48,000 fans came to see the first indoor baseball game ever played. It was an awe-inspiring sight, which excited even those involved from the very beginning.
Before then, we'd only seen it with 100 people maybe in it, and the workmen and everything. But the first day when they opened the thing up and it was full, it really did something to you.
The first game was an exhibition between the New York Yankees and the newly named Astros. And the first homer in the Dome came from the incomparable Mickey Mantle.
All right, here's the leadoff batter now. Mickey Mantle, and he drives one into deep center field. Wynn backs up. He's on the warning track. Here's the wall jump. He can't get it. It's a home run. Mantle hit it 406 feet from home plate. And the roar of the crowd, here it is.
After Mantle's homer, the Astros settled down and wound up winning the game 2-1 on Nellie Fox's single in the 12th inning. A few days later, on April 12th, at the first official National League game played in the Dome, 21 NASA astronauts were on hand to greet their baseball counterparts by throwing out 21 first balls. The game itself was a rather dull affair, with the Phillies shutting out the Astros 2-0. And even though the Dome was an overall success, a few details that had been overlooked began to cause problems right away.
I was on my way to spring training. I stopped through, and I went into the Astrodome. It wasn't quite finished at the time, and I looked around, and I told the reporters there, I said, they're going to have a problem with the ceiling, because when you look up and the sun shines through, you know, you get a big glare. And they said, no, everything has been checked out. I said, I guarantee you, you're going to have a problem.
In the beginning, when you couldn't see the ball off the roof, I mean, it was almost scary because, I mean, people just couldn't see the ball. I mean, there was a lot of panic taking place. And they actually had to get people up on top of that stadium and paint those glass-plastic combination slats that, you know, was supposed to allow the sunlight to come in and let the grass grow. And when they painted those, obviously the grass had no chance. AstroTurf started.
AstroTurf made its debut on April 18th, 1966. And it not only changed the game, but the meaning of the word groundskeeper, too.